In the last video, we learned about setting up process hole operations. In this video, I will discuss some of the options you have within process hole to customize the motion to your specific needs. Each tab within the process hole panel has a few parameters you can use to get the exact motion you want for your part. This video will focus on the holes and process tabs where you can change the order of cutting and even change specifics of the operations. To get started, open the parameters of the process hole operation. I am using the one made for the radar mount in the process hole setup video, but nothing I will discuss in this video is specific to that part. In the Holes tab, you will see a list of the solid holes selected for your operation. You can right-click to delete specific holes or delete all. Holes are automatically sorted with a minimum distance sorting method, but additional advanced plane-based or operational sorting methods are available just below the hole list in the sorting block. The four options you have are by tool, by hole, all tools in plane, and all holes in plane. The by tool option is the default and will perform exactly as if you were to program the process with individual operations rather than in a process hole operation. The by hole option is a powerful sorting method that is only practical to accomplish with process hole. It will perform all operations on each hole before moving on to the next. To do this without process hole would take a new set of toolpaths for each hole and could result in hundreds of separate toolpaths rather than just one. The all tools and all holes in plane options perform just like by tool and by hole, only broken up into sections with only holes that are in the same plane. This can help to reduce multi-axis motion during the operation. For now, let's choose the by hole option and move on to avoidance geometry. Here, you can select surfaces or faces of solids to use as your avoidance geometry. I'm going to choose some of the surrounding surfaces to ensure that there are no unwanted collisions. Now we can move on to the process tab. Here we see the operations library and the operations contained within. Notice the operations library file name is surrounded in a yellow box. This means that the library file has been changed in some way since the process hole operation was created. This will not affect your operation, but you will need to reload the operations library file if you want to experience any of the changes made to the library. As an added benefit, this workflow allows you to share part files without needing to attach the library file as well. Reloading the library file is as simple as clicking on the file icon and selecting the library again. With our library file reloaded, let's now look at some of the ways we can edit the operations without needing to change the library file at all. In the process list, you can right-click on an operation or select it and click the Edit Operation button to open the parameters of the operation. Here, you can change any parameter that isn't global to the process hole operation. Even though it seems as though you can change every parameter, anything that can be changed in the process hole operation will be overridden later and will not affect your toolpath. Any changes made will not affect the original operations library file, as they are only made to that specific process hole operation. Let's confirm the operation and look at the motion. Backplotting the operation will show the tool changes and all the sub-operations completed for each hole, just as expected with our sorting method set to by hole. Finally, right-clicking on the operation and selecting Explode Process Hole will expand the process into individual operations. In this instance, it results in 48 total operations, something that would have taken very long to program from scratch. Each of these operations can now be edited in their entirety. Now that you know how to sort and edit basic process hole operations, in the next video, I'll go over how you can create multi-axis hole-making processes with beautiful linking motion, all within process hole.